Dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. In this module, we will discuss about the different types of biopesticides, including microbial biopesticides, bacterial biopesticides, viral biopesticides, fungal biopesticides, nematode biopesticides, protozoan biopesticides, plant incorporated protectants, biochemical biopesticides, pheromones, and natural plant products. Starting with the first slide, that is of introduction, destructive activities of several pests, including insects, fungi, and weeds, they cause huge economic losses to the agricultural products in terms of quality as well as quantity. With advancement in the development of chemical pesticides, this problem was resolved to a greater extent. But the excessive use of chemical pesticides has resulted in environmental contamination such as soil and groundwater pollution. Sometimes the presence of pesticidal residues in crops also raises food safety concerns among domestic consumers. Therefore, there is an urgent need to develop some eco-friendly alternates for the environmental protection. Synthesis of biopesticides presents cost-effective solution to pest problems. Biopesticides are generally derived from living organisms, I have told you earlier, and they possess pathogenicity against specific target pests. Biopesticides include bioinsecticides, biofungicides, and bioherbicides. The main reasons that are associated with the use of biopesticides are they are less destructive and environmental load is also less. Only target species are affected and they are effective even in small quantities. They degrade quickly. Coming to the second slide, it deals with the general classification of biopesticides. Under the classification of biopesticides, first class is microbial pesticides. Major group of biopesticides is constituted by microbial pesticides. They do not act on non-target species, and the active ingredient present in the microbial pesticides, it can be a virus, fungi, protozoan, or bacteria. They suppress the pest by producing a toxic compound that is inhibitory to the pest growth. Approximately 200 microbial biopesticides available in more than 30 countries with their affiliation to Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, that is OECD. Bacterial, viral, fungal, predator and other biopesticides, they claim 74%, 10%, 5%, 8% and 3% of the biopesticide market respectively. Microbial biopesticides, they are delivered to the crop plants either in live form, dead form, or sporulated form. Now, the microbial biopesticides, they are further subdivided into five types depending on the type of which type of microorganisms are involved. These five subtypes are bacterial biopesticides, viral biopesticides, fungal, nematode, and protozoan biopesticides. Coming to the subdivision of the microbial biopesticides, first one is bacterial biopesticides. This is the general form of microbial biopesticides. The most commonly used microbial biopesticides is Bacillus thuringiensis. These bacteria, they produce cry proteins. These cry proteins, they produce toxins and kill the insects by binding to their midgut receptor. Bt biopesticides is prepared from the strains of Dendrolimus, Kutzkaki and Galeriae. Bacterial biopesticides, they are further subdivided into four categories. Crystalliferous spore formers, that include Bacillus thuringiensis. Second division is of obligate pathogens, that include Bacillus papillae, potential pathogens like Serratia marcescens, and the fourth division is facultative pathogens like Pseudomonas aeruginosa. The main reason for the wide acceptance of spore formers for commercialization is their bioefficacy and biosafety. Their primary targets are insects. However, they can be used for biocontrol of unwanted viruses, bacteria, fungi, etc. As an insecticide, their specific targets are moths, butterflies, beetles, mosquitoes, and flies. In case of insects, they are effective only if ingested. But in case of pathogenic species of bacteria and virus, these colonize in the plant and wipes out the pest. Now coming to the next classification of microbial biopesticides. It includes viral biopesticides. Viruses have a unique property of host specificity. Due to this property, they can infect closely related species. For example, bacteriophage, it is a virus that can be used as a pesticide if it is attacking disease-causing bacteria. Omnilytics, it is a USA-based company, has developed phage products for the treatment of bacterial diseases in plants such as bacterial spot of peppers and tomatoes. More than 700 insect-infecting viruses, they have been isolated from various orders of insects including Lepidoptera, Coleoptera, Diptera, Hymenoptera and Orthoptera. Some of the viruses that have been commercialized for virus control biopesticides are granulosis virus, nuclear polyhedrosis virus, poxy virus, DNA containing baculovirus and RNA containing retrovirus. These are used globally for pest control of field crops and vegetable crops. They have high efficiency against plant chewing insects, gypsy moths, sawflies and pine caterpillars also. Commercially used virus for the designing of phage pesticides is baculovirus. Now, the nuclei of the host insect cells are the place where baculoviruses develop. Now, when the host insect feeds on baculoviruses, the infectious viral particles are liberated inside the pest and get activated due to suitable survival conditions. Once the baculoviruses enter the larval gut, the protein overcoat of the virus undergoes disintegration within a short period of time. Thereafter, the viral DNA infects the cells of digestive system. After a few days of infection, the digestive system of larvae becomes weak. As a result, the larvae cannot digest the food and ultimately dies. These baculoviruses pose no threat to mammals, fish, plants, birds, and non-target species. Sudden outbreak of baculoviruses within host population can control the disease completely. Baculovirus have a major advantage that they can provide a suitable alternate to chemical pesticides and antibiotics. Among all the microbial biopesticides, baculoviruses claim 6% of the market share alone. Coming to the mechanism of viral pathogenesis. Virus gets replicated inside either the nucleus or cytoplasm of the target cell and gets expressed there. Expression occurs mainly in three phases. First phase is early phase and it occurs from up to 6 hours after infection. Second phase is late phase that occurs after 6 to 24 hours of infection. And very late phase, it occurs up to 72 hours after infection. Virus-infected nuclei results in the production of several polyhedral and number of granules within a single cell. As a result, enzootics, they are created that are responsible for the depletion of pest population. A significant impact is created on the economic threshold of pest due to decline in the pest population. The examples of viral biopesticides are Cydia pomonella granulosis virus against codling moth that causes damage to the fruits like pears and apples. Next classification of microbial biopesticides is fungal biopesticides. Many horticultural and field crops, they become prone to diseases which are caused by fungal pathogens. This leads to a loss in the crop quantity. In order to get rid of fungal diseases, farmers make the intensive use of fungicides without knowing their further effects. Fungicides result in the deposition of toxic compounds that cause harm to living beings and environment. Moreover, the fungal pathogens develop resistance to a particular fungicide after few generations. Pathogenic fungi can be used to control certain type of pests. Pathogenic fungi, they are amphibious in nature, that is, they can survive both in aquatic as well as in terrestrial habitats. Pathogenic fungi, they are known as entomopathogenic fungi when they are linked with insects. Entomopathogenic fungi are good microbial biopesticides since they have multiple mechanisms for pathogenesis. Their target point is the gut epithelium or integument of the pest insect. Within the integument, the fungi create their conidia. Some fungi, such as streptomycetes, they act against insects by the production of some toxins like actinomycin A, cyclohexymite, nobovirusin. Example of entomopathogenic fungi include Bulveria vaciana. This fungi infects the green vegetable bug and green and brown mirids. Now the question arises that how fungi attack insects? The answer is simple, that fungi have the ability to penetrate the cuticle of the insects. The mode of action of fungal biopesticides is variable and depends primarily upon target pest. Fungal biopesticides have one major advantage over bacterial and viral pesticides, that their efficacy doesn't depend upon their ingestion. They require optimum conditions for their proliferation, such as cool temperature and humid soil. Coming to the examples of fungal biopesticides, Trichoderma harzianum, used against plant pathogens, is a fungal biopesticide that has antagonistic action against other fungi such as Fusarium, Rhizoctonia, Pythium, and some soil-borne pathogens. Muscoder albus, it is a fungal biopesticide used as a replacement of methyl bromide for post-harvest treatments. Aspergillus flavus strain AF36 fungicide used for cotton. Other strains of Aspergillus produce aflatoxin. Aflatoxin is a liver carcinogen. However, aflatoxin is not produced by AF36 strain of the Aspergillus flavus. Now, we will discuss the mechanism of action of Trichoderma. It infects the major tissues of fungal pathogen. Enzymes are secreted by the Trichoderma that dissolves the cell wall of fungal pathogen. Trichoderma consumes the cell contents of the target fungus and its spore multiplication takes place. Mycotrol ES and Naturalis L are registered biopesticides that have been derived from Bulveria vaciana against mealybugs, aphids, leafhoppers, thrips, and weevils. Next classification of microbial biopesticides is nematode biopesticides. Entomopathogenic nematodes represent other group of microbes that can be used for pest control, including white grubs, gnats, weevils, and some species of Cecidae family. These organisms are responsible for suppression of stem borers and soil-borne pests. Stenorhinema and Heterorhabditis genus, they contain most commonly used nematode as infective juveniles that attack the host. Infective juveniles, they have various routes for entry inside the host, such as cuticle, spiracles, anus, and mouth. Bacterial symbioids, they are released inside the hemocoel of the host. Host gets killed within 24 to 48 hours after the release of symbionts. Large biomass of EPN can be obtained under in vitro as well as in vivo conditions using either solid media or liquid fermentation. Now coming to the next classification, that is protozoan biopesticides. They have not been declared as much successful as biopesticides. Microsporidia belonging to the genera Nosema and Verrimorpha have some capacity to attack the Orthopteran and Lepidopteran insects. Hoppers have been reported to be more sensitive to Microsporidia as compared to other insects. Examples of protozoan biopesticides are Cruiser, Heteromas, Nema BIT, Grubstake. Next class is plant incorporated protectants, PIPs. These are pesticidal substances that are produced by the plants due to their genetic modification with a specific gene able to produce the respective substance. Since these crops or plants, they possess foreign gene from different species, they are also called GM crops. The most widely used genetic material is the isolation of gene from bacteria Bacillus thuringiensis and its introduction into genetic material of the plant. The BT modified plant starts producing toxic cry proteins which act as pesticide when the plant is fed by the pest. Common examples are BT cotton, BT brinjal, BT tomato, BT corn and some others. Initially the BT plants were having only limited acceptance, but in the last 15 years the acceptance of genetically modified crops, that is GM crops, has increased dramatically, and the examples include Cry1AC, Cry2AE, Cry1F, Cry2AB2. Now the Environmental Protection Agency, that is EPA, is the nodal agency which ensures that PIP products should be carefully tested on feed crops and human food to meet human safety standards. EPA only regulates protein and its genetic material, but not the plant itself. EPA evaluates for short term, that is allergenicity, eye and skin irritation and toxicity, and long term including reproductive and nervous system disorders, birth defects and cancer, health impacts on humans, environment, non-target species, resistance, etc. Coming to the next set of biopesticides, it includes biochemical biopesticides, the chemicals that are derived from natural products which act against the target pest in a non-toxic way. They are termed as biochemical biopesticides. These substances that interfere with the mating or growth process or attract or repel the pest are also included in the category of biochemical biopesticides. The biochemical biopesticides, they are further divided into two categories depending upon their mode of action. First category is pheromones, and second category is natural plant products including essential oils, phenolic compounds, etc. Coming to the pheromones, they are volatile chemicals which are emitted by living organisms used to send messages to individuals, usually of the opposite sex of the same species. Pheromones released by one organism travel through air or water medium and reach the second organism of same species, where they are detected by the receiver. In case of insects, the pheromones are recognized by the antennae on the head of the receiver insect. Pheromones, they can range from small hydrophobic molecules to water-soluble peptides. These are classified into two groups. First is primary effect pheromones. These pheromones, they are regulated through the gustatory or test sensilla and induce the chain of the physiological effects. They have very limited value in insect pest control. Second is release effect pheromones. These pheromones regulate through the olfactory or smell sensilla. The sex, aggregation and alarm pheromones come under this category and are widely used in the insect pest management. Now coming to the next class of pheromones, that is sex pheromones. These are the chemicals which are released by the female insects to attract the males for mating. and are used most extensively in combination with Lepidopteran in pests. They are used in place of light traps to selectively attract insects or disruption in pest mating. Next type is aggregation pheromones. These are produced by insects such as wood invading beetles to indicate to others the presence of a good food source. They are reported in the management of the boll beetle, that is Anthonomus grandis, pea and weed beetle, Cetona lineatus, and stored product beetles, that is Cetophilus siamis. Alarm pheromones. These are produced by the insects that are under the attack from a predator. Leads to the movement by the insects away from the source of production. They are highly volatile and have low molecular weight, hence they are used very limitedly in insect management. Coming to the next classification, that is plant and their products. Plants have been employed as pesticides since ancient times. Prehistorically, plant parts like leaves, flowers, stems, roots, etc., they were used as insect repellents or pesticides in agricultural fields and storage. The use of leaves of Azadi Rashta indica, this is neem tree, flower buds of chrysanthemum species, parts of eucalyptus species, osimum plants are common examples of plants that are used historically for their pesticidal properties. With the advancement of science, it has been discovered that several higher plants, they have the ability to synthesize and produce numerous secondary metabolites. These metabolites, they can be extracted and have the potential to be used as biopesticides. The common metabolite chemical from plants can be classified as essential oils and phenolics. Now we will discuss about plant and their products, including essential oils. Secondary plant metabolites present in their parts like leaves, root, wood, bark, stem, flowers and fruits, etc. Monoterpenes, sesquiterpenes, phenols, simple alcohols, ketones, coumarins, etc., they are responsible for the fragrance or aroma of the aromatic plants. Essential oils are volatile in nature, and they have been reported as insect repellent and potential inhibitor of the growth of various types of fungus, microbes, as well as the larvae of insects and moths and weeds. Essential oils, as well as their pure components including eucalyptol, eugenol, osimin, myrcene, paracimin, menthol, they possess pesticidal properties, hence they are regarded as botanical pesticides. Essential oils are botanical pesticides. They have following advantages. First is they are eco-friendly in nature. They have low toxicity against non-target organisms including humans. High effectiveness against a wide range of pests and diseases of agricultural and medical importance. Multiple mechanism of action. Due to the large number of active ingredients in each blend, the development of resistance is less likely. And lastly, low health risk during application due to low toxicity of residues. Now, coming to the mechanism of the action of essential oils. The inhibitory mechanism of essential oils is not completely understood, but these probably act as a neurotoxic agent for the insects. They act on the nervous system by disrupting the ion transport and release of acetylcholine esterase. They interrupt the functioning of octopamine, that is a neurotransmitter, which results in total breakdown of nervous system of insects. Antimicrobial activity can be either microstatic, that is the inhibition of the growth, or microbicidal, that is killing of the microbes. The efficacy and mechanism of EOs depend on their composition as well as on the type of the microbe. Overall, the mechanism involves a series of biochemical reactions inside the cell, breakdown of membrane integrity and increased permeability, disruption of membrane transport and other metabolic regulatory functions, depletions of the ATP pool. EOs are allelopathic in nature and have been explored for their herbicidal properties. They inhibit the seed germination and plant growth in beets. Germination inhibition may be the consequence of blockage in the water uptake, disruption of the activity of metabolic enzymes, means those enzymes that are involved in the glycolysis, and oxidative pentose phosphate pathways. Volatile constituents of essential oils, they alter the electron flow into cytochrome pathway, which leads to the decreased ATP production and alteration of energy demanding cell processes. These are used as preservatives of grains, fruits and vegetables during their storage. Various essential oils are reported as main active ingredients in packaging materials during packaging and storage. Next category is of phenolic compounds and other biochemicals. The plant products like pyrethrins, nicotine, picrotoxin, propolis, azadirachtin and fusapyrone, etc., they are also used for insect pest management. Pyrethrins are the most common natural compounds that are known for their potent insecticidal property. These are the organic compounds that have been derived from bud of the chrysanthemum cinerifolium flower. Propolis is natural resinous substance that has been obtained from leaf buds and bark of poplar and conifer trees. It contains proteins, amino acids, vitamins, minerals and flavonoids. It has antibiotic activity, antifungal activity and antibacterial activity. Propolis has been found to inhibit the post-harvest pathogens like cinerea and expansum. Nicotine and picrotoxin are also used as insecticides historically. Both act as neurotoxins, nerve axons and synapses. Another extensively used plant product extracted from the seed kernel of neem is azadirachtin. It contributed much for the development of several commercial biopesticide formulations. More than 100 commercial products are developed with azadirachtin, including margosan, bioneem, azatin, safers, valgro, nimbin, and these are used successfully in many parts of the world. Apart from these, some other natural compounds like juvenile hormones, rianodine, they have also been used commercially for insect control. Students, I would like to conclude that in this module, we learned about the different classifications of biopesticides and that especially of microbial biopesticides including bacterial, fungal, viral, protozoan and neem-based biopesticides. Thank you.